Thank you very much. Good to be back in Columbus. Well, the last tour was good. We had a week here, so we got to know Columbus a little bit, and we had a great time. Talking about time, time may be the big boss, and all of us may be in its claws. But imagination perhaps give us the route out of time. So I'd ask you now to come with me 4.5 billion years back, when our planet was actually a dead planet. And they say, a little bit like this piece of asteroid returned to the planet yesterday, all the ingredients for life may actually have come from a meteorite. And it just so happens, tonight, so, in front of your very eyes, you'll see the necessary elements open up the fire of life. Well, that's quite a serious job of work to have done, so I think that's my lot for the evening. But it's actually increasingly difficult to tell the fake from the real. And many of you here may be more than a little surprised to know that what you're listening to now and looking at is actually a very fine avatar. Now, unlike the excellent ABBA show, where the avatars may be on average lost about 20 years and 20 pounds, we decided to do something a little different with my avatar. In fact, 20 years older, 20 pounds heavier, and completely bald. Meanwhile, the real Big Gabriel is lying horizontal on a Caribbean beach, looking like a Greek god. Meanwhile, the avatar gets on with his business. And having got fire, we may need some help getting something else. So we call upon the legend of the deep, Mr. Tony Levin. Whose adventures can always be followed on TonyLevin.com. But what he doesn't show on that side is that we go back far enough to have had dinosaurs as our pets and a full head of hair. Yeah. Meanwhile, we're back to the washing of the water. Feel like I'm sinking down. touch the ground, and I need something to turn myself around. Go away, away, away toward the sea. Can you lift her and carry me? Roll on, roll on through the heartland to the washing up the water, we'll make it all right. Let your promise reach me, let she reach me tonight. Let it go, it's a part of me. It's hurting now, getting this love on time. So tough to stay with me, I'm coming through. I'm that will let me get to sleep. In the washing of the water, will you take it all away? Will something take this pain away?
You may have noticed that since we were last chatting, the planet has become much more densely populated. Fortunately, populated with an extremely talented group of individuals here. On my left, long-time studio companion and touring many instruments, Mr. Richard Evans. Next to Richard, first time out with us, on trumpet, French horn, keyboards, and voice, Mr. Josh Spank. One more time for the legendary Lemon. And compared to his 47 years, the next gentleman has only been working with me for 44 years, the amazing guitarist, Mr. David Rose. Next to David, first time out with us, he joined us for a track on the album, and we were blown away. Here he is, just Mr. Donnie. And next to Don, with a full range of talents that you will see as the evening progresses, on cello, on keyboards, on voice, Ayana Witter Johnson. The maestro we've had a pleasure working with over a number of years, all the way from Paris, Monsieur Manu Katché. Another first time out with us, but enormously talented, Marina Moore on violin and viola. So you have to ignore us for a little bit because we have some growing up to do. such a struggle. Getting through these changes, and it all seems so absurd to be flying like a bird when I do not feel that. So I grew up on a dairy farm. And the only person that got really worried when you talked about AI was the bull. Now, on the farm, AI meant only one thing. The vet was coming for a process called artificial insemination, AI. Now the entire human race is in roughly the same position as the bull. And we have a decision to make, because AI on the one hand could make all of us obsolete, could find wonderful new ways to destroy each other, or we could, for instance, look at the patterns, brain patterns, communication patterns of other intelligent species we share the planet with and learn how to communicate with them before we destroy them all. We could also give every single child the very best personalized education. And possibly with new forms of healthcare delivered through sound, light, electricity, and magnetism directly to cells, we could offer high-tech healthcare at very low cost to every child in the world. It's a decision point. And another fun thing for us might be to create a globe to which, because we're storytellers at the end of the day, to which everyone could upload and embed their story, their experience in the map of the world in a way that wouldn't let it be forgotten, denied, or buried. So everything that's happening now, or shouldn't happen, could be seen and hopefully challenged. This is a process we call Panopticon.
Let's see what clothes are feeding. as your idol captured in the contest.